welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, I've been a naughty boy. I've got to do me Hail Mary. Right, we've got an Hail Mary here. Now, this is a bit of a strange one, this. It has won Best Bottle Conditioned Beer at GBBF, the Great British Beer Festival. So, I imagine it must be a good one. But it's one thing that kind of separates people down the line. You fall one side of the fence or the other, it seems, anyway. Because as far as I know, I haven't read up on the beer at all, because I don't want to get too many taste notes. I think this is one in really important times, not even to catch a glimpse of a taste note, because I want to be surprised by it, you know. But it seems to me that it's been splitting the kind of reviewing community and everything else straight down the middle. You either love it or you don't, you know. You either like it or you hate it, sort of thing, you know. Right, so I think it's been spiced with things, but I don't even know. So I'm gonna kind of play it by ear. It is an Hail Mary. I don't want to get too close because I really, really don't even want to catch a taste note. It's a 6 ABV. Handcrafted beer, beautifully executed. That's in bad taste, isn't it? And considering this Hail Mary, put all conditioned. Let's pour it and go for it. Get it going quick, very quickly, before I lose too much of the smells off the thing. Have we got that? Alright, go. Yep, that's about right. There we go. Right, let's get the nose. Oh, whoa. Well, I'm already liking it. Straight on the nose, I'm getting all sorts of kind of dark fruits. Kind of a Christmassy sort of thing. Like these Christmas... like a potpourri, like a Christmassy sweet mixture, you know, like when he's not quite a mince pie, but kind of the sweets and things. Right, it's kind of escaped on the nose now, so let's use me Humpty Dumpty. Let's have a pour out and see how we go. That is lively. Hang about. While it settles, I'll tell you who the brewery is. RCH Brewery. RCH Brewery, I'm trying to think of another one they do. Can't think of one offhand. Really quite effervescent when it comes out of the bottle, so I'm really going to have to pour seriously slow. With a bottle conditioned beer, you shouldn't really do what I've just done. Let's pick it up, drop it, pick it up again. Right. Yeah, we got crystal anyway. Good lord. We're getting kind of almost like Army and Navy sweets, almost that cinnamon sort of clove sort of background. Where's my beer paper? There's a beer paper, that'll do. Let's get the light on it. Where are you? The light there. That is beautiful, isn't it? Isn't that beautiful? There's the carbonation. Quite hefty, quite exuberant, quite excited, and it's holding what looks like a natural head, what looks like a wheaty head. I hate all this head business. It really gets in the way, honestly. I would have a flat beer any day of the week, you know, as long as it is a little something just sparkling on the tongue. I don't really need all this, I really don't. But it's what people like. I find that any aroma oils in there go, and they're gone almost before you've got your nose to them. And then once they do that, then they're just getting in the way of everything. Now I'm getting kind of like a like a rocket smell there as well. You know, like the, not rocket up your nose. But the salad rocket. But there's fruity, dark fruity notes in there as well, like a raspberry, sort of squashed raspberries. And right, let's dive in. Cheers. I like it. I like that. That's very strange. Very, very, very strange. There's a little bit of salt in there. A little bit of just sparkling around on the tongue. Some kind of minerals and things like that. Sherbet-y almost. It's like a sun-dried tomato there. It's black currants. There's all sorts of little dark but slightly sharp dark fruits. There's also something like grape or something. Tastes like almost there's a Nelson Sauvin in there as well. But you've got grape. There's not these so much the aromas, the taste and aromas of orangey stuff and grapefruit stuff that you quite often get in beers. They're not really marking through. These are currants. It's all sorts of those kind of Christmassy notes. Almost like a mulled wine. Almost a distant coriander in there as well. But you're getting even stuff like cherries and strawberries in there. There is a tiny bit of something a bit brighter in there as well. A bit lemony, maybe a grapefruit pith or something. A slightly underdone, underripe grapefruit segment as well in there. Right, let's have a read what's on it now. Complexity of cask conditioned, nice. Yeah, aroma of cloves, coriander and ginger. I didn't quite get the ginger there. No, I'm not getting much ginger. And that's usually very pronounced. The palate provides touches of rum, raisins and sultanas with a dry fruity finish. Yeah, there's that piff finish. This beer has been exclusively brewed by Paul Davey of RCH Brewery. And I'll tell you, it contains coriander seed oil. Pardon me. That is really nice. I like that. Right. Not quite sure how to say this, but two things, right? It says on here, serve cold. That could be a mistake. I really do think that could be a mistake. And that could be what's drawing the kind of reviewers apart. Cool, not cold. Ah, right. Because I would say that one would be a mistake to serve cold. I'd say just a little bit below room temperature. I wouldn't even go as far as cellar in it. Kind of cellar temperature in it. You don't need a cellar. But that is lovely. That is nice. Right. I'm going to pour see if there is any sediment in this crystal. And I've got to be careful how you pour though, because it's really fizzy. And that is with a little bit of yeast, slightly cloudier. Didn't you get that? Now, one quick word on that. For one, look, it's helping to keep the head, make it nice and smooth. For two, yeast very often adds flavours, it often kind of helps to grab hold of those flavours as well. Kind of like the irons, not the irons, kind of like rubbing a balloon and your air goes like that to it, not mine, you know. But the flavour molecules stick onto that as well. In the same way that they stick on, unfortunately, to those finings that a lot of breweries use. This is glorious. Now, let's see what it's like with the yeast. Oh, it's beautiful. That is beautiful, and you do almost get, not quite, but almost get a ginger there as well. You can kind of see that. Yeah, that's really beautiful. A pepper as well, we're getting on that now. That is beautiful. Go get it, go buy it, go try it. Without a doubt, buy it and try it. Because I think that's one, whether you like it or not, it's a quality, good beer. And I just think it's nice. I think you will like it myself, but there you go. There is a slight bitterness with the yeast in. Slight. Dry bitterness on the finish. Which is quite unusual, really. Usually it brings out the peachiness. But anyway, I love it. Cheers. Bottoms up. Chin chin. Cheers. Oh, and Merry Christmas with that one, I think. It's like a Christmas pot. Cheers.